Good evening and welcome to our evening prayer service for this evening. Tonight, our reflections will be centered around the holy darkness and the beauty of darkness. As we worship, we invite you to a time of meditation over the scriptures and the music that are sung. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, the love of Christ that guards our hearts and minds, and the joy and consolation of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Dark
RSV joins them as two things that belong together. I am black and beautiful. The scholarship behind this decision would seem to be reflected in what follows. Do not gaze at me, because I am dark, because the sun has gazed on me. This may seem an unusual passage to meditate on during Advent, yet many of the images of Christ and the Virgin Mary we are accustomed to seeing this season portray them with white skin, as if from European descent. This can give the incorrect impression that Jesus was white, a belief that has been used to defend notions of white supremacy. This passage offers a helpful contrast that is also more historically accurate. The refrain from a hymn for the feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe, which identifies the woman in Song of Solomon with the Virgin Mary, puts it like this. O Mother dark and lovely, hear the poor who come with our song. Lead them into Jesus' kingdom, where they truly do belong. A reading from Song of Solomon, 1st chapter, 2nd through the 6th verses. Let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth, for your love is better than wine. Your anointing oils are fragrant, your name is perfume poured out. Therefore the maidens love you. Draw me after you, let us make haste. The king has brought me into his chambers. We will exalt and rejoice in you. We will extol your love more than wine. Rarely do they love you. I am black and beautiful. O daughters of Jerusalem, like the tents of Kedar, like the curtains of Solomon, do not gaze at me because I am dark, because the sun has gazed on me. My mother's sons were angry with me. They made me keeper of the vineyards, but my own vineyard I have not kept.
Christ Jesus, we meet the God who knows our weakness and bears the wounds of the world. Therefore, let us be bold as we pray, trusting that God draws near to those in any kind of need. We remember that you made us beautiful, but the image of God in us can be obscured by harmful societal messages or expectations around beauty. Our own feelings of guilt and shame can also cause us to doubt our belovedness as children of God. We lay at your feet any past wounds or actions that diminished our sacred worth. Enfold us in your arms of love and comfort, Lord. We remember before God all who are frightened, those who have received unexpected news, all who dream of a better day, all whose relationships are strained or broken, all who must make difficult decisions, all who must leave their homeland, all for whom the world has no room, all the joys or concerns we offer now in the silence of our heart. In your wide embrace, O God, we place all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, trusting that you will receive them into your heart of mercy, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation.